Alright, so we got another trailer for Color Splash. The game still looks as gorgeous as ever. I'm hoping the music will be pretty decent too. However, it's clearly not shaping up to be the Paper Mario experience that I typically enjoy. I've been lurking around some comment sections, looking at some debate for and against Color Splash. I'll just address some arguments I commonly see, in hopes of delivering my views towards the current situation at the same time. 1. You shouldn't judge the game so critically when it isn't even released yet. It's set to release in October. There's no way the game will be drastically different from where it's heading. Starting off, I would have had the same mentality, but we're way too far in the development cycle now. At this point, it isn't far off to judge it for what we see now, because it's probably a pretty good representation of what the final product will be like. 2. The game isn't terrible. It's not even finished. It'll be a good game. Sure, my judgment is only so limited as long as I don't have the final product in my hands. I'm not going to dismiss the game as bad or call it good. However, I don't see why it's okay to say that the game will be totally fine, but not okay to say otherwise because of early judgment. 3. Paper Mario fans will hate it if it stays the same, and hate it if it changes. This is entirely dependent on how those two things are brought about. Take F-Zero, for example. Have you ever heard tons of people asking for a super innovative F-Zero, which could only happen if we find a controller interface that's particularly suited for F-Zero, like Miyamoto said it would have to have? No, people just want a new F-Zero like the previous games. How often do fans complain that Pokemon has the same formula? Fans want the series to stay fresh with respect to its own foundations, not an entire formula change that classifies the game into a different genre, or a rushed version of a previous entry. Look at Mario Tennis Ultra Smash. They removed tournament mode, there are no notable special minigames, no unique court locations, no ring shot mode. Heck, it didn't even have an intro. That's not the kind of content a general fan wouldn't want or expect. Even so, the game didn't provide what would seem like natural additions. It has online, but you can't even play with your registered friends. You can play online in doubles, but you can't team up with a stranger or your registered friends. The visuals are great, and the core tennis experience is still there, but the core Mario Tennis experience is lacking. Ultra Smash didn't live up to the average standards of the Mario Tennis games. Remember that they are fans. Fans want the usual, but better. That's how it works. If you make a total rehash of a previous game and call it their favorite thing, they'll dislike it. If you start to make drastic changes that change the fundamentals of what they enjoyed, they'll probably dislike it, especially if they're poorly executed. Fans want what they've grown to love. Straying too far from foundations and failing to improve on them will naturally result in disappointment. 4. Paper Mario fans are so entitled. Quit complaining. My apologies. I'll just accept whatever they give me and have no opinion. Nintendo, thank you ever so much for giving us another Paper Mario game. We should all be very grateful. They didn't have to give us the game in the first place, you know. It's not like Nintendo was a video game company that makes a living by selling us entertainment, silly! I care about this series and want to see it do better, so I'll continue to criticize it. I have no problem with them trying to reach new audiences, but it's almost like they're abandoning the old ones. If you want to see this from a business perspective, why wouldn't you appeal to the fans that make up most of the audience? 5. You never know how the game will end up. Remember how people complained about Wind Waker? Once again, it's releasing in October. I'd be surprised if the final product was any different from what it seems like now. In terms of being an actual good game or not, yes, I'll refrain my judgment, but not in terms of what the game will be like. Additionally, Wind Waker didn't change the fundamentals of Zelda. The formula wasn't changed to make it different from what fans knew Zelda for. Link didn't suddenly have all of his key items become depletable. It's not like temples only required you to have the right limited items at the right time to proceed, or you had to have a secret item never hinted at to beat the boss. This comparison doesn't work. 6. I don't understand why Paper Mario fans want the exact same game as before. If it isn't like TTYD, it's bad to them. Hey, I won't deny that some people think that way. You have people like that in every fanbase. I'm not saying that viewpoint is necessarily bad, but I digress. I doubt anyone really wants a literal, bare-bones copy of the dolls in your door. Plenty of Paper Mario fans enjoyed Super Paper Mario. By asking for a new Paper Mario game, they ask for just that, a new Paper Mario RPG with a good and unique storyline, creative characters and partners, a fun battle system, cool dialogue, interesting locations, and what makes Paper Mario what it is. As long as that criteria is met, most fans will be happy. Everyone keeps referring to the Thousand-Year Door as a return to form because it's arguably the closest to form Paper Mario has gotten. We want another Paper Mario like that. Nintendo clearly has different ideas for what Paper Mario is about, and even went as far as to literally change the genre to action-adventure. So simply saying that we want a new Paper Mario game isn't enough. The majority of fans don't want another Sticker Star, and while Super Paper Mario wasn't bad, something along the first two games is generally preferred. 7. Nintendo doesn't want two RPGs. They want to do something different, so let them. If you want an RPG, play Mario and Luigi. First of all, just because they're the same genre, it doesn't mean that fans will get the same experiences they crave for. Second, while I get that Nintendo always wants to try something drastically new, change doesn't have to happen for the sake of difference. It's not like people were complaining about how two Nintendo spin-offs were RPGs. Allow me to provide some examples. Imagine this. Atlus decides that they don't need two RPG franchises, so they keep Persona as the RPG and make Shin Megami Tensei a puzzle action adventure. You gain absolutely no rewards from battling, the variety of demons is limited to about 20, demons function like the depletable stickers, and the only way to win boss battles is by obtaining special demons from a hidden side quest. Did you want a story-driven experience?
Nope!
Instead, you choose a side before the final boss and that's it. If you're an SMT fan, this probably sounds horrifying, but I'm not done yet. Do you love Soul Calibur and not Tekken? Too bad. Namco decided they didn't need two fighters, so they made Soul Calibur into an RPG fighter. You select three moves from a list to use before battle, and that's all you have. You level them up by winning, which increases their power and your defense. Also, the more you damage your opponent, the stronger they get, thus removing any advantage you earn from dealing damage. Additionally, there are no new characters. Instead, you just have clone character variations of Taki, Shangua, Kilik, and Astaroth. Once again, I'm sure Soul Calibur fans would be pretty displeased with this. I trust you've caught my meaning by now, right? Fans simply want what they have known to enjoy. Just think of literally any favorite video game franchise of yours, and imagine how far off the company could change it. Why should you simply accept what you don't prefer? Can someone legitimately and seriously answer this one for me? Why is it wrong for you to criticize your favorite franchise for becoming something that you don't want it to be? I don't understand. Color Splash and these examples have something in common. They aren't simply trying something new, that's not the problem. They're trying something that's totally unlike what they were known for, and in some cases possibly flawed. What's the point of making a bunch of enemies for players to battle, which is a major part of the game, if they don't have to fight them? What's the point of choosing any other underleveled attacks to take in battle when the three you've constantly leveled up are the only ones strong enough to fight with? Why should you forcefully accept that your favorite fighting game became totally unlike what you loved it for? 8. Give the game a chance. Well, I kinda did. I was pretty open, despite it seeming what I was hoping it wasn't, but now I can see that it's doing just that, so for now, I'd prefer to refrain from purchasing it. The thing is, fans gladly gave Sticker Star a chance. The game ended up not being the experience they wanted, so they disliked it. Now another game is following the vein of Sticker Star, so their skepticism is justified. Why spend the money if it doesn't seem to add up to your standards of a good Paper Mario? It happened with Sticker Star, so why try again? For now, all that the fans can do is make their opinion about the franchise's current state known and hope for the best. Or... you can simply say absolutely nothing, and focus your thoughts and energy in the hopes that Nintendo changes it for the better. It's best to do nothing than try it all. Phew, okay. That's just about the most common ones. As I said before, I love the Paper Mario franchise, so I'll continue to criticize it, but it almost feels like I'm beating a dead horse. Once Nintendo gets set on a trend, they seem to stick with it for quite a while, so I don't know if Paper Mario's future. Anyway, as it stands, my opinion's changed based upon the new footage, so I'm definitely not very interested in buying the game at the moment. I'd like to be swayed, but I doubt that'll happen. Thanks for watching. If you have any counter-arguments yourself, or whatever it is you want to say, you know what to do. As for me, I'm gonna cut the video short. I'm being too critical.